everyone, this is Isha Dema, a Tarayana Club member of Jimmy Sherbling Central School, here to take you through the topical discussion on waste management. On the panel today, we have Pimay Wangmo, Jamang Chodin, Sonam Zangmo, Tsing Yudin, and Chitin Wangmo. To begin with the discussion, the first question is to Ms. Pimay Wangmo, and the question is, what is waste management and what are the common methods of waste management?
Kuzampula to all the viewers and my friends out here. It's great honor to all of us to be a part of this show. And I would like to thank Ms. Ishii for welcoming us to this very discussion about waste management. Now, if I go on to my question, as we all know, waste management is the form of collecting, transporting and disposing the waste products by segregation and using our three methods. They are reduce, reuse and recycling the waste products. If I convey you in simple term, waste management is something that each and every household and business owner in the world should dispose of their products and substances that they have used in safe and efficient manner. I guess your second question was, what are the common methods of waste disposal, right? Okay. Although there are many methods to dispose the waste, let's look at some of the most commonly used methods that we should know about waste management are, number one, recovery. Resource recovery is the process of taking useful discarded items for a specific next use. The discarded items are then processed to recover material resources or convert them to the energy in the form of usable heat, electricity or fuel. Number two, recycling. The main idea behind recycling is to reduce energy usage, to reduce the volume of landfills and help to reduce soil and water pollution, air and water pollution. Moreover, it also helps to reduce greenhouse gas emission and preserve natural resources for future use. Number three, composting. Composting is one of the best methods of waste disposal as it can turn unsafe organic products into safe compost. On the other side, it is a slow process and it takes a lot of space. Composting is an easy and natural biodegradation process that takes organic waste, that is remains of plants and garden kitchen waste, and turns into nutrients for their plants. Thank you.
Thank you for sharing us about waste management and some of the common methods of waste disposal. The next question is it necessary to segregate waste into different categories at the point of origin? And the question is to Ms. Jamang Chodin.
I also would like to join my friend in wishing all the viewers and my friends out here a very warm Kuzuzampola. Now, if I go on with my question, yes, it is necessary to segregate the waste into different categories because, number one, to maintain the value of material. For example, paper that's already mixed with an organic waste cannot be recycled because it is already tainted. Number two, if waste materials are not managed properly, it all gets mixed up in landfills. Number three, different waste can harm differently and the waste disposal technique is also contrasting. Number four, if waste materials are all mixed up in the landfills, it could lead to contamination of land through leaking of harmful chemicals into the atmosphere. So lastly, your waste is your responsibility and be responsible. Waste no time arguing what a good man should be one. Therefore, I would like to urge all the viewers here to take my words into consideration and save our only motherland.
Thank you for sharing us about the need to segregate waste at the point of origin, and I hope that now every individual will start to segregate their waste at their household and manage their waste properly. The next question is to Ms. Sonam Zangmo, and the question is, what are the problems of public health and aesthetic associated with solid waste management?
Thank you, Ms. Ishtema, for the question. The question was about the problem of public health regarding the solid waste management. So first, let me define what solid waste management is. It is defined as an action or activities required to manage waste from its inception to the final disposal. The problem of public health is increasing every year because of the solid waste. It could be mainly because of the rapid modernization. The modernization has its own share of disadvantages. One of the main concerns is pollution, be it land, air and water. The waste are ultimately dumped at the waste municipal vehicle, collection vehicle, from where it is further collected by the area municipalities to be dumped at the landfills. Human beings are responsible to take care of the environment and the waste that they produce, but they do not. If I cite an example, recently we went below MIK for the cleaning campaign. It was disheartening to see that the place were filled with different kinds of waste. However, the Tarayana Club member cleaned the place by picking up all the litters and made the place look clean. Due to the insufficient facilities, it is difficult to collect all the waste and transport to the final dump site. If at this stage the waste and disposal of management waste are not properly done, it can cause serious impact on the health and can give problem to the environment. The waste that is not properly managed from the household or community are serious to health and can give or lead to spread of infectious disease. Unattended waste lying around attracts flies, rats, and other animals that in turn spread different disease. The wet waste decomposes and releases a bad odor that leads to unhygienic conditions and thereby increases the risk of health. So plastics are very harmful to our health. Thank you.
Thank you for telling us about the issues related to waste management. Now, as we are aware about the health issues we have if we don't manage our waste, I hope that now people will take care of their waste so as to live a healthy, happy life. The next question is to Ms. Sringhadin. Questions surrounding the issue of waste disposal have traditionally received a great deal of attention. However, the focus needs to be on the more sustainable goals of waste minimization and recovery, reducing, reusing, and recycling our waste. What is your view on this?
So, thank Ms. Sishtima, thank you for the question. I feel that instead of giving our immense effort on discussing issues on waste disposal, we should be thinking more broadly and focus on what is required in the current state. Despite small population, Bhutan's economic growth has led to an increased urbanization. For that, we have to move on with more sustainable measures to help our country remain clean. Because with rapid modernization, in many places, the amount of waste produced would be much more than what we produce now. So, in order to address future problems related to waste management, we can look for ideas and proposals from people, government, and focus solely on minimizing waste production in the country. And in order to do that, we can follow the three simple procedures, which includes reducing, reusing, and recycling of waste, whereby we can manage the waste and we can make a proper use of it. And the other thing is that in our country, people in our country are so much familiar with the waste disposal thing. But today, many people, however, know how to dispose a particular waste, be it degradable or non-degradable, differently, for it was traditionally considered an important thing to do. Clean Bhutan also said that compared to other countries, waste in our country is not a huge problem. However, it is growing rapidly, and since 2014, waste in country has doubled from 250 grams a day per person to half a kg a day per person. In simple terms, to overcome the current situation, our focus needs to be on more sustainable goals of waste minimization and waste recovery, that is reducing, reusing, and recycling, as I mentioned earlier, of the waste. Thank you.
Thank you for sharing with us your views on the need to focus more on the sustainable goals of waste minimization. The next question is to Ms. Jitsin, and the question is, how do you practice waste management at home? What are the few steps to initiate waste management program in your school?
First of all, thank you very much for your question, La. Now, from my opinion, waste management should be initiated in every household because our one step towards it can greatly help our Mother Earth from degrading every day. Although all of my friends have already shared their views and opinions on the importance of waste management, Nevertheless, I would also like to say that the main purpose of waste management is to ensure the solid waste to be managed in such a way that it protects both public health and our natural environment. So some of the ways and methods through which I practice waste management at home are, firstly, use of cloth bags instead of plastic bags. This small measure can greatly reduce the amount of waste we produce in our house every day. Sometimes we should know that the simplest solutions are the most effective ones. Secondly, reuse containers and water bottles. Durable containers and water bottles can be used for good purposes at home. Thirdly, segregation of dry waste and then wet waste. Dry waste is also known as non-biodegradable waste, and wet waste is also known as biodegradable waste. Effective segregation of this waste means the life in the landfill increases and the risk to our ecosystem goes down. Lastly, proper disposal of hazardous waste. Hazardous waste includes fertilizers, paint, batteries, and any kinds of chemicals which have negative impact to our environment. The second part of the question is about how I would initiate waste management at school. So some of the ways and methods through which I will initiate waste management at school are, firstly, segregation of waste. This is one of the most important and the first step towards reducing and managing our rubbish. We can keep different dustbins for different kinds of waste in the school. Secondly, by following 3 R's, and they are reduce, reuse, and recycle. Waste can be always reduced. If not, it can be reused. And if it cannot be reused, it can ultimately be recycled. Thirdly, starting with a composting program. Composting is an aerobic method in which organic materials are recycled. Lastly, making a landfill or a waste pit. In fact, this should be our last resort because there are several disadvantages in having one, but however, for a time being, it can reduce our waste on the land. Thank you.
Thank you, Jitin. I hope that the steps you have mentioned today will be practiced at every household and at schools as well to manage their waste properly. The next question is to Ms. Pemo Ongmo, and the question is, what are the impacts of solid waste on the environment?
Thank you for this question. If I switch on to my question, as the number of urban households are increasing, the volume of solid waste is increasing at an alarming rate. Everyday waste is disposed in the forest, open areas, and even in the rivers, causing serious damage to the environment. So if I talk about waste, waste are of 3 types. They are organic waste, inorganic waste, and sanitary waste. Organic waste are biological and degradable waste. Inorganic waste are minerals and degradable synthetic products, and sanitary waste are used in medical equipment, for toilet paper, and sanitary pits, among others. The major problem is that when we dump this waste all together, this leads to soil and water contamination in larger scale. This unawareness gradually contributes to the climate change. So if I sum up or if I make it short, solid waste takes long time or duration to decompose, which cause harm to the environment, like making landscape look dirty, slow bleaching of the particles, slow release of harmful chemicals, and broken bottles and glasses may injure animals and humans as well. So lastly, I would like to request all the viewers here to reduce the use of solid waste as far as you can and be responsible for your own waste. Thank you.
Thank you for telling everyone about the impacts of solid waste on the environment. The next question is to Ms. Jamyang, and the question is, what is hazardous waste and how can we deal with it?
So thank you for your question. Firstly, hazardous waste are those waste which are harmful and dangerous to both the environment and the health of human beings. It's a threat to all if it's not managed properly. I see managing waste as one of the biggest challenges that the people across the globe face. Hazardous waste can take the form of solid, liquid, surges or contained gases, and they are generated mainly by chemical production, manufacturing, and other industrial activities. Hazardous waste are classified on the basis of their biological, chemical, and physical properties. These properties generate materials that are either toxic, ignitable, reactive, corrosive, infectious, or radioactive. Hazardous waste are those materials and substances that have qualities that make it potentially dangerous to both the environment and the human health. Now, if I share some tips to handle hazardous waste, number one, use proper storage materials. Number two, maintain proper storage areas. Number three, understand the requirements to handle the waste. And number four, give awareness to the neighbors to segregate the waste properly. So lastly, I would like to urge all the viewers here to remember that your small waste is not just a small waste. Analyze that it has the biggest impact ever, and there is no such thing as away. When you dump anything away, it must go somewhere. Thank you.
Thank you, Jamyoung. With the information you have provided, individuals at home are now aware of hazardous waste and the methods they can use to deal with hazardous waste. The next question is to Ms. Sonam Zamo, and the question is, what are the different types of waste and why burning waste is not an acceptable practice of solid waste management?
Actually, there are different types of waste, but the five major types of waste are solid waste, liquid rubbish, organic waste, recycled rubbish, and hazardous waste. What our friend Jitsen and Jamyoung had elaborated about the hazardous waste. So when we burn all those waste, the pollutants from burning those trash are released primarily into the air and close to the ground level, where they are inhaled easily with no pollution controls. Ash that remains contains concentrated amount of toxic materials where they are blown away or seep in the soil or groundwater. So it is harmful to both our environment and as well as organism if you look into environmental and health perspective. We all know that the waste contains millions of chemicals, and when we burn it, these harmful chemicals releases the odor. That is the bad odor. Some even burn their sanitary pads, which are the harmful, which are very filthy thing that human ever bear up. At the girls' hostel, we burn the pads in one of the pits every week, and we see the black smoke from those pads. So we can analyze the consequences from burning those pads and from those habits. So most commonly, the waste are burnt around the rural areas in and around their houses. So it would be better if you do some campaigns around the rural areas and make them aware about the consequences that they would face later about burning the waste. So that's why the burning of waste are not accepted in Bhutan by now. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Sonam, for making us aware that burning is not an acceptable practice to get rid of one's own waste. The next question is to Ms. Ring Yudin, and the question is, at waste management, our primary work is to minimize waste generation. What do you foresee as the biggest challenge in managing waste in our country?
So when we talk about waste management, we are literally referring to minimizing it. Regarding this issue, I don't think there's much of a big problem because our country is still developing, and unlike other countries, waste production in our country is comparatively less. However, if we look deep in further, there are some problems really hampering in managing the waste. Major problem could be that people in our country act selfish and never expect. Even regarding cleaning the surrounding, we have a habit of working for ourselves and those known to us, instead of working as a whole for our country and our people. And this is why we refer to as unpatriotic badness. While in other countries, people are ready to stand up anytime, anywhere for their people, it is us who lag behind in terms of cooperation. And we lack cooperation, we are lazy. We are too dependent on government and expect them to do all the work. Instead of waiting for the government to collect and recycle our waste, we can go take our own initiative, collect and separate, recycle our own waste. It can reduce the workload of the government and provide a helping hand to the waste managing system. And on top of that, there are some general problems that we face in our everyday life. With rapid socioeconomic development and increasing urbanization, our people are facing an increased amount of solid waste production. But the more serious and grave problem is that the composition of the waste is changing from biodegradable to non-degradable waste. That is, there is a growing trend of people throwing and discarding electronics like phones, laptops, televisions for a newer version of their models. The people have changed their methods to segregate waste. But the facilities to manage waste are still at infancy. By this reason, waste production. So these are some issues I feel that we need to look out for and the challenges that we are facing in waste management. This is why we should unite among ourselves to help our country remain clean, to maintain clean and healthy environment for now and all times to come. So in order to keep our country clean as it has been, let us join our hands, face our common challenges together and keep it safe and green forever.
Thank you, Sring. I hope that individuals will now act less selfishly and work together to keep the nature clean. The next question is to Ms. Jitson, and the question is, what is your stand on the ban of plastic in our country? How do you think this move will help Bhutan to brand to the outside world?
Once again, I would like to thank Ms. Ishii for your question. Now, the ban of plastics in our country is one of the most wise decisions taken up by our government to reduce our production of waste. In fact, I believe this should be introduced in every other countries, and I am very much glad to know that as of February 2019, 55 countries have imposed such bans in their respective countries. Now, coming back to Bhutan, Bhutan first initiated this particular move on April 1999, and I rated in Queensel that it is the third reinforcement since 2005, and the second attempt was made in 2009. Fast forward to 2019, we had been still talking about the need to outlaw the use of plastic bags, and thankfully on April 1st this year, we completely banned the use of plastic bags in every nook and corner of our country. Plastics are the major source which pollutes both our land and water. It imposes a serious threat to our environment, and it is no secret to every one of us that it is causing us so much today. We live in this earth as if we have somewhere else to go, but the truth is, this is the only home we have. Let's go green because there's no planet B. I found this one quote very relevant to my question, so I want to share it here, and it goes like, if trees gave out Wi-Fi signals, we would have planted so many trees that in the process, we might have saved our Mother Earth from degrading, but too bad that it gives out only the oxygen we breathe. By banning plastics, Bhutan will be able to brand to the outside world, and I once heard that we made headlines all over the world when we first banned the use of plastics. Even though our country is very small and tiny, by banning plastics, other countries will appreciate our move and then provide their full support and help towards us. So lastly, to all the viewers, it's time we realize and reflect our own actions and say no to plastic usage. Thank you.
Thank you, Jitson, and everyone on the panel for your time today. With this, we end up our discussion, but I hope that today's discussion does not remain as a simple talk between the panel and me. I hope that waste management is taken as a trend to help keep the environment clean. I urge everyone to switch on to Plan A, waste management, so that we will never have to seek for a Planet B. Let's be responsible human beings. Mother Earth has always given us her best, and it is on our part to keep her healthy and green, to protect her from pollution. Let's act wisely. Let's be responsible of one's own waste, and let's hold hands to keep the Mother Earth healthy and green. Thank you.
This is Sonam Zangmo of 12 Arts A, currently studying in Jigme Sherpling Center School.
Hello everyone, I'm Sring Yudin from in.
Yes, it's. Sorry.